Yeah. One, two, three, come on.
What's up, everybody? I'm gonna put the disclaimer at the bottom of the screen, but I do not own the rights to that music. But I needed to give that introduction to talk about what I wanted to talk about, and that is the correlation with drums in modern gospel or Christian music, and the point that it's trying to achieve. I needed us to hear that first. That was from Ty Trivett's latest album. The track is called "Give Thanks," but that introduction serves as a wonderful. The introduction to that song serves as a wonderful background for what I wanted to talk about, and that is like how drums are being used today in worship services, in gospel music songs, in Christian songs, CCM, and all of the above. So this is a rather churchy, preachy post. That's what this is all about. Okay, so let me just dive right into it. For any drummer, any musician, you know, you've been hearing and knowing lately that drums have been all the rage for modern gospel music, Christian music, especially playing the tom-toms. Like I've been playing drums just about all my life, since about age 11, and in church and playing and so forth, but I've never seen this proliferation of like tom-tom use for gospel music as we are in this common era. It works and for a lot of songs. For some people, I think they use it just as fads, just as because it's the latest trend. But I see it serves a purpose, and a purpose that hopefully nobody misses. I mean, if you're a Christian, if you are about holy things and about godly things, you know, hopefully you'll see the connection. I know, you know, for traditional churches, they don't like a whole lot of drum activity in the churches. You know, it used to be. I mean, nowadays people are becoming more modern, but hopefully people don't see it as just an add-on. Hopefully people see value into why it's so connected to praise and worship. And this is the reason why. Basically, in Revelations 4, the fourth chapter, the Revelator John gives a description of what heaven is like. I mean, he goes through, you know, what the angels are doing. He goes through who he sees. He sees a great white throne. He sees a rainbow above the throne. It's a very beautiful picture of what John the Revelator sees. And one of the verses he mentions in around verse 5 is that, "And out of the throne proceeded thunderings and lightnings and voices." And then it goes on to give a few more descriptions. Now, I hope people don't run past that too quickly, because thunderings and lightnings, I mean, it's a very active place. And shout out to my pastor I grew up with, Pastor Streeter. He kind of taught this message to say that heaven is actually a very noisy place, a very active place. Not noisy as in cacophony, as in bad noise, but just that you got to understand, it's not like a quiet place where people are just, you know, humming very softly or communing in themselves. Heaven is a very active and a very alive place, and there's a lot going on. So John the Revelator sees the actual throne of God, and he says out of the throne comes these lightnings and thunderings and voices. So for me, when I put the connection together, you know, as a musician, as a drummer, I'm seeing that the drums are actually supposed to spiritually, musically emulate what's coming out of the throne, the lightnings and the thunderings. Thunderings would be the bass drum, the tom-toms. I mean, as we can understand what a thunderstorm is, there's a lot that's happening, there's a lot that's going on. We don't think it's musical necessarily, you know, but that's what music is. It's putting sounds and putting it to rhythm, putting it to music. And so that's what the drums are doing. They're with, whether it be the bass drum, tom-toms, I could put that as synonymous with those thunderings, as what we would hear out of a thunderstorm. The snare drum, a little bit particular, that would probably be more of the lightning. You know, as we hear lightning, as lightning crackles, and it has like a higher pitch sound. That's what the snare drum does in particular. Now, you know, for most African American gospel music, you know, we're used to a 2-beat or 4-beat or more rhythm section, but that's why I feel like, or more of a consistent pattern of a rhythm, I should say. But that's why, you know, now in more modern day CCM music and more gospel music, they're switching it up now. They're doing more more rhythms, polyrhythms with the tom-toms, with the bass drum, with the snare drum, as to, again, kind of simulate the thunderings and the lightnings that are happening around the throne of God. Because, again, if we're caught up in the praise and worship of God, we want to get that sense that we're right there at the throne, right? We want to get a sense of euphoria, a sense of ecstasy that we're right there by the throne of God, worshiping him. So, you know, through the drums are just one part of that, you know, helping us get a sense of a small foretaste of what it could be like, what it would be like when we're worshiping around the throne of God with our praise and our worship, right? And, you know, and this last thing I'll end on, I do remember seeing, and this was some time ago, this was some years ago, through Spiritual Eyes, I do remember being in a church service, and the drummer was playing, everybody, the band was playing, you know, singers were singing, you know, it was a high time in the Lord. But I do remember looking over to the drums, you know, again, I'm partial to them. And I remember them crashing the cymbals as normal. And somehow I saw like this wispy wind that as soon as the cymbal hit, the wispy wind just kind of flew up and went into the sky, went into the atmosphere. Obviously, you know, it wasn't visible to the naked eye. It's just something that I just kind of noticed and kind of glanced at, but it still reminded me of scripture, you know, in Psalm 150, you know, praise them with the cymbals, with the high sounding cymbals. I mean, we think that it's just horizontal, you know, we're just doing all this activity, all this musicality, and it's just, you know, just for our purposes. But I really do believe that those kinds of things actually do praise God. So when we praise him with the cymbals, with the high sounding cymbals, it actually, you know, we don't see it with our natural eye, but, it, you know, spiritually, in the spiritual realm, you know, musically, those things actually do give praise to God. The cymbals. So just lastly, in review, the cymbals and the snare drum, more like the lightning. The bass drum, the toms, they're more like the thunderings of what it's like to be like to give praise and worship around the throne of God. So this is just something to consider, something to ponder over, especially for musicians, especially for drummers. You know, hopefully that can give us more depth and more weight to what we do so that we could be into it a little bit more. It's more than just following a formula, more than just kind of doing it just because we have to or need to, but or because it's in style or the latest thing to do. But this is something that we can, that actually gives praise to God in ways that we may not know and see or understand. But if we have faith, knowing that it does make a difference in our praise and worship. So had to get that off my chest. It's been on there for a while. Hopefully somebody's blessed by it. Write something in the comment section. Let me know that you got this. Peace.